This is my 2008 Mac Pro that just replaced my dual PowerMac G5. Not much has changed with my other setup. I still have the 23-inch Apple Cinema screen, and I did pick up a cheap MIDI controller. Still have the Mac games, and these are some of the new PC games I've gotten. The G5 and the Mac Pro share the same case qualities. On the front panel, you have your power button, your headphone jack, two USB ports, a FireWire 400 and a FireWire 800 port. The power supply for the Mac Pro is located on the top, the G5 is on the bottom, which I like better, and there's also dual head DVI ports for just about every model. The case opening switch is the same as the G5, you pop the lever and you can pop that down to lock it. On the back panel you got your three USB ports, your FireWire 400 and 800 ports, your in and out for optical, your in and out for analog, and you also have dual gigabit Ethernet ports. The Mac Pro opens up the same way as the G5, you pop the lever and pull off the side. One thing that differs from the G5 is the arrangements of the hard drive. You simply just pull them out, and on the front bezel there's a number, and that same number is also located in the system profile. The Mac Pro uses two front-side bus memory cards that do hold FB RAM, which is more expensive. It's a server-based quality RAM. I have 4 GB in the top card, the bottom card's empty. The Mac Pro also supports up to 32 gigs of RAM. My Mac Pro came with an 8800 GT, which is SLI ready. It's also a single wide card, so it does support another graphics card. The biggest discriminative feature between the G5 and the Mac Pro is the Mac Pro has two optical slots, the G5 just has one. I'd like to talk a little bit about the Mac titles, mainly just the small titles. The large titles are just fine. The smaller titles, they have two things going against them. A, the Intel platform. A lot of them weren't designed to run under it, so they'll run slower, or actually won't even start up at all. And secondly, they also have to work against Leopard. Now, a lot of them, again, won't start or run right in Leopard. So it'd be a great idea to keep an installation of Tiger on your computer just to run some of these less popular titles, such as No One Lives Forever series, or Tron, or Hexen. And this is all mainly a developer problem. This isn't an Apple problem. These companies aren't actually touching their games after they release them. I haven't had much time to play some of these PC games on my Mac. I do have Vista 64-bit installed. I played Jericho and Assassin's Creed, and I was just blown away. It runs great. So in conclusion, the Mac Pro is probably the best PC I've ever owned. It's fast, it's easy, and it's quiet. I played games on it. I've done video editing, photo editing, audio stuff on here, and the best of all is the wattage it uses is extremely low, so it's very power efficient. It won't bring up your power bill. So I would recommend this machine to anyone who has the money.